Everyone is looking for love. And they're desperate to find it.
We must show them love.
We must introduce them to love, to Jesus. To Jesus. For this is true revival. Love is all they need. Everlasting love. Rise up and go and show them love, revival love, supernatural love. Jesus is love.
Are you ready to be powerfully used by God? Because He has His eye on you, that you might do exploits for Him, that you might share His light, His life, His word in the world that you live in your sphere of influence. So get ready, because there's an acceleration of anointing and empowerment and calling on your life. And today with me, I have Andrea. It's so good to have you here. Andrea Aasen, you are the apostolic leader and director of Extreme Love Ministries. And I'm so excited about all of that, because you've just launched out on your own, in your own ministry, after many years of serving with us. And we saw the apostolic calling on your life, and we knew that you needed to fly with your own wings while we are in your cheering section. And so I want to help our viewers today understand the process of being prepared to be an effective vessel of the Lord, because there's so many of those that are watching that God has great things for them. But sometimes people might think, well, I don't know, I wouldn't know where to start, and I don't know, I don't have any education in that, or I don't have any experience. But you could have written the book on all those.
Oh, because
So you came to our ministry a number of years ago as an intern in intercession.
Correct.
And you learned how to intercede, although you already were quite an intercessor, but it was the love of your heart. And then after the internship was over, you moved back because you just felt in your spirit the leading of the Lord to do that. So you just responded to the word of the Lord. And you got here and you ended up cleaning my house. I need a house cleaner at the time. So you said, I'll do that. Right. You prayed through the house and you cleaned. You were so faithful and so humble, allowing the Lord to work within you, not knowing His full plan for you, because you never thought for a moment that you'd be on the mission field somewhere. You never thought that you'd be going to Cambodia. It wasn't on your radar. But when you got invited to Cambodia, tell us what happened.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, I had no idea. I didn't even know where Cambodia was on the map, Patricia. And God just stirred my heart. I gave Him my yes. And it starts with your yes. It always starts with that radical obedience. And anytime there's radical obedience, you'll see a change. You'll see a transformation in yourself. You'll see a transformation in what God brings you into. But I just said yes and going over to Cambodia. I love to travel, but other than that, there wasn't anything that
Any
I saw
real
beyond
call.
That.
It wasn't three dreams and a vision
no,
or anything like that.
No, not at all.
You responded to an invitation. And on that first trip, we weren't going to keep you there after the first trip yet, but you went over there. And I remember, because we work very much in anti-trafficking. Mm-hmm. That's one of your specialties over there, rescuing children from those situations where they've been sold into sex trafficking. And so we get over there, and right in our midst, you and I and Craig were actually walking across the walkway there, and a grandmother came to us with her granddaughter and tried to sell her for sex to Craig. And that broke all of our hearts.
Just wrecked us.
Something happened in you
just
at that
time. Just wrecked us. It was like I always had a heart. I always knew that it wasn't okay. And loved children. I was actually studying medicine before this and thought I was going to go into pediatric medicine. So it was like the giftings, the things that God had placed in my heart, the desire to see people transformed, to see people healed, that was there. I just didn't have a grid for how to put it into anything other than I had never seen anybody in ministry. So I was raised not in a church, and I didn't have a grid for that. And it was like that moment when we saw that little girl. I think she was about 4 years old at the time.
She was so young.
And the fear and the terror in her eyes, mm-hmm. in that she knew it was coming. This has happened to her before. Mm-hmm. And it was like the burden dropped, and I knew that this was not okay. And mm-hmm. it went from a head knowledge to a heart knowledge, yeah. at that point.
And you just wept and wept. Like, I remember you being in an intercession for days after mm-hmm. that. You couldn't get that out of your heart. You couldn't eat that night at the dinner table. You were so taken by the burden of the Lord, because that's how He feels. And so now you have the burden, and then it said, you know what, Andrea, we're going to start a outreach center here, and the Lord's shown me that you're going to be the leader overseeing it. You've never been on the mission field before, but the Lord spoke to me about you. And there was even other people on the team that have been with us longer. But when sure. the Lord chooses someone, it's not because you have seniority. It's not because you're even more gifted. It's just He chooses whom He chooses. He knows you and the call that He has on your life. And so you again said yes.
Yeah, and it started there.
And so, you got thrown into the situation. I mean, you got to understand, we were in Poipet, Cambodia, and it was so dark yeah. there at the time, and there was so much corruption and everything going on. We set up this outreach center. People came in from all over the world to just love on the people, and we were able to expose a lot of things, teach the villages about the traffickers coming in, showing them what was happening to their kids afterwards. We were able to do intercession at the borders and make a lot of change. But in the midst of all of that opening up and a lot of good things happening with people working together to see the kingdom advance, you also got introduced full on to levels of corruption and exploitation that a lot of missionaries who have been on the field for 10 years haven't seen what you saw in that first year, and it broke your heart.
Yeah. Yeah. And I think it's, you know, it was an answer to prayer. I didn't realize at the time. You pray to be refined and you pray to grow in love. And the way that God brings us into those places is through those love tests and through those trials. And I'll tell you what, it accelerated me. I think I learned more in that first year than I would have probably in 10 years had we not gone through those difficult places. Yeah. And I really learned through those places to find my joy, to just grow in faith, to learn the character and the nature of God, that I always knew who He was. I always knew He was faithful. I always knew He was provider. But when you're in those situations where that's all you have is God, I love that you always say, and I've just clung to that word, it's just that God plus nothing is absolutely everything that you need. And I just so found myself in that place every day, day after day, that I just had to cling to the word of God. I had to cling to God. And despite what I saw, that I knew that God would be faithful and calling forth those things that are not as though they are. When we were in those situations where we couldn't see beyond our circumstance, that we had to believe that's all we had. Right. And it actually built character. It refined me into the place where I can walk and stand today, and I've been able to grow and walk into the new places that He's taken me because of that season.
Mm-hmm. You are one of the most solid women apostolic leaders I know in the body of Christ today. We're so proud of you, and for over the years, the work that has excelled. I mean, you go into the slums and you protect the children, and you are transforming whole slums into places where the glory lives, you know, and the children's lives are being transformed, they're being educated, and traffickers are being confronted. I mean, you are just going for it, and the fruit is really good, and we're so proud of you. But what we want to share a little bit about today is how the generations can walk together. So when we were walking together, you were younger generation who was brand new on the mission field, brand new in ministry. I was older generation with about 40 years of seasoning in ministry, but we needed each other.
Yeah, we did.
We needed each other because the older generation needs the younger generation. We got to stay fresh because God speaks differently and new things to each generation. And so we need that, but the younger generation also needs the seasoned generation mm-hmm. because we learn together. And one of the things I want to say about preparing a vessel mm-hmm. for the work of the Lord is submission and honor. And there could be many situations where you could look at, even when you were on the field that first year, that you had discernment on. And I'm sure that in your own self, you would have, you know, just wanted to act on the discernment right away. But there were some things that had to be worked through that I know you would have done it differently had you been able to make your own choice. Mm-hmm. But you submitted to the wisdom and the counsel and you walked it through. And what it did is work in you wisdom and insight and promotion because of the level of honor that you walked in. So maybe you have something to share about the importance of what you've learned as far as the importance of submission and honor.
Yeah, it's so important, Patricia. I mean, I look at the places that we went and the situations that God put us through. And had I not had you and all of the team that was seasoned and mentored, walking along with me, teaching me, showing me how to do it and modeling it. And that's one of the things that got me through it is you not only showing how to do it, but then also leading by example.
Right.
And there were times when I think everybody kind of has those moments where you think, oh, I'd do it differently,
right.
or I wouldn't go about it that way. But that place of submitting and
yeah.
humbling yourself, going low
yeah.
in those places, because oftentimes those that are put apostolically over you to lead you and to guide you, God is leading them. And so knowing and trusting that they're getting wisdom and direction from the Lord, and it might not be, you might not be able to see
right.
at that point where he's taking them or see clear vision
right.
into where they're being led. But because of the wisdom, because of your years of experience,
mm-hmm.
then you are able to actually mentor me in that process.
Yeah, it's so amazing. And I'm so thankful for modern day technology because
yeah.
we had many late night phone calls and Skypes
yeah.
and all of that because we can mentor today online, which is really amazing. But what I want to finish up with just before the break, because we've got some great things to discuss afterwards about what you're doing in Phnom Penh right now in the nations of the world. But what I want to share is that I have found that when I get tested on my submission level and my honor level, if I pass that test, there's always promotion on the other side.
Yeah.
Even if the one I'm submitting to, I don't agree with, and they could be totally wrong. I mean, I've seen that in the past where, you know, my leaders have said, no, I want to do it this way. It turned out that they were wrong, but I submitted to them and God honored the honor. And what I noticed with you, because you've passed, I think, every single submission and honor test, but what I've noticed with you now is even with your team that you're working with now, and you had a lot of challenges internally.
Yeah.
And you worked it through with the love of God. There was a lot of heartbreak. There was a lot of tears. You worked it through well. But now, when I look at your team, they're like you. They're full of honor. They're full of submission. They're full of creativity and boldness and faith. And so you were able to carve out in the spirit this realm of submission and honor that now others are coming in under that covering and the standard in your base is raised because it's beautiful. The love environment that you have built over in Cambodia is just absolutely beautiful. But we're going to take a break right now. We'll be right back. And know this, that you are being groomed right now by the Lord to become a vessel of his honor and glory and his goodness. And sometimes it's not easy. And there's some of you that you're thinking, owie, I didn't pass the submission test. I didn't pass the honor test. It's okay. The blood of Jesus will forgive what's what's in the past, but he'll give you another chance. You're going to have another opportunity to pass those tests and to be able to overcome, because that is what is going to groom you for long-standing, stable leadership in the future and for fruitful ministry. We'll be right back.
What an hour we are living in right now, all around the world. You can see injustice, human slavery, genocide, poverty. But the reality is that the light is so much greater, so much bigger than the darkness. And I want to invite you to use your voice. Be a voice and come and join us in helping to set the nations free. We are hosting a fundraising and awareness campaign called Be a Voice. Well, there are so many ways that you can get involved. Maybe you own a business. We would love if you would consider partnering your business as a Be a Voice business that gives back. You can also buy products that give back. We have women that are coming out of prostitution, backgrounds of trafficking, that are learning how to sew and are being discipled through the process. They're making handbags, shirts, scarves, products that you can purchase that will directly impact their lives forever. You can also host an event. And this is as simple as getting your friends, your business colleagues together, maybe hosting a backyard barbecue or a church festival. If you want to get more involved, you could even host a gala or a product service event that gives back. But it is so easy. We've had people all around the world that have partnered with us to raise funds and awareness. It's a great way to get your network and sphere of influence involved.
I just want to tell you how one woman who owned a coffee shop made a difference and changed the life of a woman in the Everlasting Love program. She sponsored a day for human trafficking to stop slavery. She did it by inviting local vendors, local artists, and a local up-and-coming country singer. And the funds that were raised that day supported this woman in her first year coming out of prostitution.
Being a voice is so easy. We've even partnered with a 9-year-old girl, and she had a creative idea to make bracelets. She sold them for $5 each. We were actually able to sponsor 11 children that are coming out of poverty and exploitive situations. These are kids that had the potential to be trafficked, but because of her faithfulness, we were actually able to take them out of those dark places and put them in school. They are changed, transformed lives because of this little girl who decided to be a voice for those who had none. Well, maybe you're thinking that you want to host an event, but you don't know where to begin. That's okay. We'll actually help coach you in making your event a success. We'll give you marketing and promotional materials and even help you in the planning process. It's such an easy way that we can all do our part. Together, we will be one corporate voice that will change the nations and set the captives free. Join us and be a voice.
Now, Andrea, both of us love mentorship. We
Yes.
love the mentoring of the Holy Spirit, who is with us all the time. I love mentoring people like you and those that God has given me to mentor, and you have become a mentor of many. And so over in Cambodia, which is where you're based actually right now, you're an American 501c3, a nonprofit ministry, but you also have one in Cambodia. And from there, you're reaching out into Vietnam, into Iraq, into different nations. I mean, you're just going for it. It's just beautiful, the work that you're doing. But when you have people come over and serve you in the field, like let's say they're going out to the slum to help the children who, you know, are very susceptible to being trafficked in that, mm-hmm. or you're working in the brothels and you bring people out. What is it when people come to your base that you want them to leave with? Because everyone that comes on your outreaches, and I highly recommend to you, you got to go on one of these outreaches. And if there isn't one scheduled, she'll schedule one for you. Just go on extremelove.com and, you know, you'll find out more information about how to join the outreaches. But what is it that you want your people to take away?
Oh, well, I hope they leave with a piece of God's heart. And I hope they leave just knowing how much He loves them and how much He loves the nations. And we love to mentor. We love to take those who have never been on a mission trip before and to actually walk them through praying for the sick. And sometimes we have people that have never before shared the Word of God. We take them in to evangelize and do Bible studies and teach the children. And actually, they find out that it's easier than they think. Yeah. And they're able to actually take that back to their nation, and they're able to just replicate what they've learned in Cambodia or wherever we are during outreach back into their areas.
I love the way that you give opportunity and that you push people beyond their comfort zone. And that's what mentorship is all about. That's what a good mentor will do. They'll be right there with you and then push you a little bit beyond your comfort zone, and so that they can see what God will do in them and through them. And I hear so many great reports of people coming back from the field that say, oh my gosh, my life will never be the same again. I've tasted God in a new way. I've seen Him move. I've seen Him move through me. And it absolutely transforms a life. But also, not only in those skills, but the other thing that you mentor in so well is character and building community and love. So share a little bit about the importance of that, especially when you've got like 30 team members together, and what are the things that are important then?
Right. Well, it's always a challenge, I think, when we get people from all different backgrounds and walks of life and all different ages that come together. But that's actually when we're so powerful, when we can unify ourselves in different generations, and that we actually then can grow in that place together. But I just love mentoring and equipping, and as you said, creating this culture, this kingdom culture, where we just learn to love and be love to those that need love.
Yeah. And it's so great that usually when you go, I mean, a lot of the outreaches I've been on probably hundreds in my life, but it's like, without fail, there will be those little, what we call grace growers on the outreach team, right? And you think, oh man, I didn't sign up for this. And the Lord says, well, I signed you up for this.
Yeah.
Because that person that is maybe a little irritant is what makes you a pearl. And it's so beautiful the way that you learn to love the one who initially could be a little bit irritating to you. And we all have them. Every person might have those kind of situations. And it's so wonderful being in a love environment like what you have built over in Cambodia, where you help people even through those processes. And I love the way you mentor the heartbeat of God into each other and even for each other.
Yeah, I think we're all at a different place, and God meets us exactly where we're at, and then it's our job also to meet people where they're at. And I love that, you know, we can model it, and they watch, and then they do it, and we watch, and then pretty soon they're doing it on their own.
I know.
It's just so beautiful to see God equipping and God releasing those that He loves. I have people time and time again that say, you know, Andrea, I never knew that I could do it. I never knew that I could share the gospel, or I never knew that I could be a voice for the voiceless.
Right.
And God so often downloads strategies while they're there. We've had so many people that just personally, you know, it's like they come to release and they come to impart, which they do. That's so much a part of why they're there in the transformation of the nation, but it's also about what God does in them.
In them. And He's preparing them for the next step too.
That's right.
And it's like, it's so beautiful to see that. In fact, we've had so many people that have been on outreach with you that are now really connected to full-time missions.
Yeah.
We even have leaders on your team and those who are working alongside of you who all it was that one outreach that launched them into full-time ministry.
Isn't that incredible? I just love that. How God does that. I'll never forget, we had one lady, had never spoken in tongues. She had actually, I could just tell the first worship day that she was just a little bit uncomfortable, and brought her aside. We prayed for her. And she was so scared to step out in different places. It was the first time actually that she had heard about anti-trafficking. And now she's actually a leader. She's a leader in her church.
Wow.
She's actually led a whole justice movement. She went back to school, and now she's training as a police officer. Actually, her desire is to work within the FBI and to work with an anti-trafficking jobs within the FBI, leading teams over. So it's so amazing what God can do with our yes.
I love it. And I'm so glad you gave God your yes. And you know, you might be watching right now and you think, oh my goodness, I wouldn't know where to start. Well, I could say maybe start with just attending a short-term outreach. You could go over with Andrea, for example, to Cambodia, and you could just plunge into it for a week or maybe two and let God change your life and see what happens. Once you're there, see what happens to your heart. Remember, Andrea, that's what got her. It's a one heart experience. Inside of that was her calling. And you'll never know where God's going to take you, because there's so much darkness in the world. And of course, you see it so blatantly all the time in the environments that you work in. But our light, it belongs in the darkness.
It does. It's so much brighter than any of the darkness. And I think sometimes it actually takes coming into those places to see the hope, to see the good, to see what God's doing. I have so many times that people come and they say, oh, Andrea, I don't know how you do this. How do you go through every day and see the darkness that you see? But actually, I don't see it anymore. There's so much more light.
Infiltration of light. Yeah. Well, no kidding. Like, Poipet, after we were there for a while, you could start to see the transformation of the city, and even more so now. I mean, it was a border town where they would take children across the border in the bottom of carts and everything and drug them and load it up with blankets over top of them and they get through. But I mean, since the teams have been working on the ground there and the planting of churches, it's just exploded and it's growing in light. And Phnom Penh, the visible transformation of the city. And of course, that's not just because of one ministry. It's because of God bringing light, believers in from all over the world through all different ministries. It's transforming a nation. He says to disciple, mentor nations.
Yeah.
And that's what you're doing. So I want to highly recommend you going on Andrea's site. I would love to see you just connect with her, with her team, and prepare yourself as a vessel for God's glory to do something magnificent in this day for Him and for those who are suffering. Take your light into the darkness, because the darkness is waiting for you. Arise and shine, your light has come. And the nations are crying out for those who are hungry to manifest God, His kingdom, and His righteousness. We're going to be back in a few moments, and we have a special word and a special prayer for you. So we'll see you in just a few minutes.
Your soul is the epicenter of what happens in your life. Patricia King's book, God's Law of Attraction, takes you on a riveting journey from God's perspective through your soul to discover the secret to a life of abundance and success.
I have a word for you, and the word is this: it is time. It is time for you to arise. It is time for you to go. It is a time to give God your yes. What is going to happen in these coming days for you is going to be extraordinary, because the God you serve is extraordinary. He lives big on the inside of you. And the Lord says, it is time. It is time to accelerate. It is time to put your hand to the very purpose for which you were destined for, the purpose to which you were born. And so arise in this hour and say yes to God, to the things He's speaking to your heart. He says, fear not, for He's chosen gladly to give you His kingdom. You don't have to have it all figured out, because He's got it figured out for you. We'll see you next time. And remember this, that God loves you with an everlasting love. He really, really does. Let that love motivate you and share it with someone this week.